friends, welcome to Ratna's Kitchen. Thank you for joining me again today. I'm going to show you a very simple and easy fish recipe. It's called steamed fish with some very subtle masalas. So to start with, I'll show you the basic ingredients what I'm going to use for today's steamed fish. Here we have, I've taken red salmon fish here. You can use any fish, like you can use basa fish or ling fish or anything, but today I'm using red salmon. And I have a tomato here, curry leaves, fresh coriander, and here I have galangal. Galangal is going to bring a very beautiful flavor to this steamed fish. If you don't have galangal, you can just go simple with garlic ginger. And I'm using a fresh turmeric today. You can see fresh turmeric is going to bring a beautiful flavor to this as well. And I have some cinnamon stick, green cardamom cloves, and here I have some fennel seeds, and then jeera, which is a cumin seeds. So I'll show you how to make this easy fish steam. So I'm going to wash this beautiful red salmon. Before washing, what we are going to do is add a bit of a turmeric to it. Why I'm doing this? This is to get rid of the smell, if there is any fish smell to this thing. So it's going to take out. And if you have lemon, you can add lemon too instead of salt, but I'm using salt today. So just rub it on the fish nicely. And now I'm going to just rinse it off. Friends who are watching my video today, if you are watching for the first time, please do remember to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get a notification whenever I upload an exciting recipe. So I hope you all are going to join me from now on. So let's start the recipe now. So I'm going to turn the stove on now. And I'm going to put mustard oil. Always try to use mustard oil whenever you're cooking a fish. It's going to bring a beautiful flavor to the fish dish. So I'm just going to add a little bit of mustard oil and we'll wait until it heats up. So the oil is hot, so let's add this whole masalas. Add a green cardamom, peppercorns and cinnamon stick. For this, I'm adding fennel seeds. And I'm adding cumin seeds as well. Let's fry them. To this, I'm going to add some chopped onion, roughly chopped onion. I'm going to add some salt to the onion so that it gets fried faster. So I request you all to watch this recipe until the end, because I'm going to show some tricks and trades of this recipe so you can learn from my experience. So always add salt if you want the onion to fry faster. The reason why I chopped the onion roughly, because we are going to fry all the masalas and then we are going to paste them into a fine paste. So to this, now what I'm going to add is turmeric, fresh turmeric I'm adding. If you don't have fresh turmeric, don't worry about it. You can add turmeric powder. And this is galangal. I'm adding a piece of it. Galangal. If you don't have galangal, again, as I said, you can add ginger paste. I'm just adding the langal today. I'm not adding any ginger. I'm just, we're going to bring this Thai flavors, or Malaysian flavors you can say, to this fish. And let's add some curry leaves. And to this now, I'm adding chopped tomatoes, just one tomato. And I'm going to fry this until it's cooked properly. So I'm going to add a little bit of chili powder, red chili powder. You can add Kashmiri chili powder or hot chili powder according to your taste. As you can see, this dish doesn't need too many masalas or anything, all natural herbs. If you do it with natural herbs, this is going to come out so well, and you will just love this steamed fish. Okay, to this I'm going to add freshly cut coriander, and let's fry with the coriander as well for some time. And I'll leave it on the stove for 5 minutes for it to nicely cook. So the aroma is so tempting now, it is so beautiful. What I'm going to do, I'm going to turn the stove off and I'm going to let it cool so that we can grind it into a nice velvety paste. So I'm going to keep this aside for now. So while the masala is getting cooled down, what we will do is I'm going to sear the fish for 5 minutes. So I have turned this pan on, and then I'm going to add a little bit of mustard oil, not too much. And let me just smear this. So here I'm going to add some salt to this freshly washed salmon, and bit of chili powder. Not too much. That should do. And I'm just going to rub it a little bit on the top and on the sides. We're going to just put it on the pan just for 2 minutes. Let's just sear it just for 2 minutes. And as you can see, I've kept the water for boiling over there. If you're wondering why the water is there, I'm going to show you why I'm boiling the water little bit later. So we are going to just turn it to the other side only for 2 minutes each side. Don't cook it for too long because it's going to get steamed with the masala later on. So let's just cook it just for 2 more minutes, and then I'm going to turn it off. So let's just turn it off, and I'm going to turn the stove off, that's all. The rest is going to be cooked by steam. So let's turn the stove off. So the masala is cool now, so let's just put it in the jar for grinding. So let's see, the paste is done. And look at this. This is how the color is going to be. See the turmeric color, nice and yellow, and the aroma is too good, too good. So let's just do the next step now. So the water has boiled, right? So I'm going to turn it off. It's nice and hot. So I'll show you what I'm going to do with this. Whenever you're using a banana leaf, it is very easy. It just gets stirred up so fast. When you're folding, it can tear up like this. It is so easy. to be torn like this. So for it to be flexible, what we need to do, we are going to dip this in the hot water. That is going to soften the leaf and it will not tear on you. So I'm just going to dip it in the hot water and it will become nice and flexible. I'm going to put a little bit of masala on the top. Going to put a little bit of masala here. And let me pick up this piece. And I'm going to add a little bit more masala. Let's just put this in there, seal it. Let's do the same thing on this side. Okay, leave it aside and let's do the other one. Let's tuck these sides in. Yeah, I'm going to do the same thing on this side. I'm going to turn the same pan on now. I'm going to add a little bit of mustard oil again. Place this fish. This side, and I'm just going to cover this lid and leave it in a low flame for 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes we'll come and turn them around. So let's just 5 minutes, so let's just turn them around. Let's close it again for another 5 minutes. So friends, it's all done. So let's just turn off the stove now. And I'm going to plate this beautiful dish out for you all. So here it is, friends, all done. Nice, steamy, steaming fish. Have a look at it. The aroma is to die for, literally. It is so tempting. So friends, here it is, yummy and tasty steamed fish ready for you. You've seen how easy and very less time consuming a recipe. I hope you all like today's recipe. If you all liked, please do like, share and subscribe, and please do forward to your friends and families. I'll be coming back with many more exciting recipes. Until then, bye.